Good evening, fellow Toastmasters.
Good evening.
Fellow guests and distinguished guests and fellow Toastmasters. Kiwi. What I felt about the speech was truly, truly tremendous. I think I want to highlight a few key points that I've took away, the key takeaways from your speech. In particularly, I want to highlight is that the choice of the theme that you used for your speech was really spot on, because throughout your speech, right, I have discovered various amount of emotions and various amount of gestures that actually conveys a lot of different types of emotions and a lot of different types of unspoken words that when you're communicating, particularly regarding the hand, the gripping of the palms, it conveys a different sort of message. So good choice of selection of topics that you have. The other thing that I feel that it's very well done and something that I never thought of is the usage of body to convey length. For example, like a meter is actually from the palm to kind of the two-thirds sections of your body, and that's a meter. But for me, and I'm a little bit short, so I think it was called a meter. So that's a meter, right? So it comes to us, it never gives us a thought that actually our body can actually convey length or convey a measurement. And that's a very smart way of usage in terms of how we use our bodies. However, I do feel that there are areas for improvement. I do notice when you are finishing or wrapping up your speeches, I realized that you were wrapping up really, really quickly. And I feel that that's because of the red card that was displayed over there. So I realized that you can actually improve on your ending by actually pacing yourself a little bit. Because I see that you are having so much fun with your gestures that you actually forgot there was a timing in front. So to actually, the conclusion is very important, because as you wrap up your message in your conclusion, you leave the audience with a lasting impression on your speech. So the conclusion is very important. Yeah. So if you wish or feel there's something you can improve on. The other thing that I feel that it's quite good to improve would be your facial expression. So when you convey your facial expression, you convey a sense of confidence, you convey a sense of enthusiasm. As you change your facial expression, you give the audience the thought that you're very enthused and your eyes just lit up when you speak on a topic. And that is one way where you can, you know, look into improving in your future speeches, where the usage of facial expressions can actually add in more weight to your speeches. So just to wrap it off, I feel that you've done a good speech. Your topic was spot on, as I mentioned previously, but there are some certain areas which you can improve to work on in your future speech. And with that, I'll conclude my speech, and thank you.
Thank you very much, Allan. Our next evaluator would be David Chow, who would be evaluating Lehutang's P6 speech. Let's welcome David for his evaluation.
Thank you, Toastmaster. So today I'll be evaluating Lehutang's P6 speech on vocal variety. Actually, your speech explained a lot to me. I realized something. I didn't know you remember at first. I still remember whispering to Claire one time. It's like, hey, our photographer's not here today. we began your speech with a lot of vocal variety when you were simulating the dialogue to you and your niece. I really felt the excitement that your niece felt when you came home. Auntie, auntie! And when you said that, no, you're so tired, I can really feel that, oh, you're really, really exhausted from this meeting. So I really felt the vocal variety towards the beginning of the speech. Towards the body and towards the end, I think you put less emphasis on vocal variety and it became more stagnant. So if you could continue the whole entire speech and your thoughts of the objective of the speech, and then you'll reach more of a hitting the actual objectives. As far as your pauses, you had outstanding pauses. The speech was not rushed at all. Your pauses allow us to understand your speech and help us gather our thoughts, and we're anticipating what you're going to come out and say next. So excellent use of pauses. A great choice of topic. I think everybody here can relate. Everybody here part with our $150, and everybody here and everybody here was forced by someone or or decided to join Toastmasters on our own initiative. So a really good choice of topic, and all of us are intimately involved with your choice of topic, and which kept our interest. On the areas of new improvement, I had a little problem with your structure. It was hard for me to figure out what your actual structure is. So your organization, I thought, need to be improved. And as far as getting to the point of your speech, I didn't know till midway, almost till your speech was finished, until what your point of your speech was. Your speech-wise was very consistent. You didn't hurry up. You didn't slow down. It was very consistent, but that's not meet the objectives of vocal variety, which is the topic of the speech of this particular session. Your dialogue, even though you're being accurate, because I'm an English speaker, it's really apparent to me your dialogue was completely in English. But I mean, it works in this, in this occasion. Overall, I mean, you memorize your speech, which is excellent. You show no nervousness. You're very clear. Your timing was excellent. 5:43. That means you're very safe on both sides. Okay. So overall, I think you met your objectives. Concentrate more on vocal variety on the whole entire speech, and I look forward to your next speech.
Thank you.